Hey, what's going on guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is Varun and in this video we are going to take a look at the features of the latest NitrogenOS ROM for our Redmi Note 3, and I will also be showing how to flash this ROM if you are a beginner. So without any further ado, let's get started. So before getting into the features of the ROM, I highly encourage you to hit that red subscribe button, because I will be posting many more of these awesome content on the channel. And if possible, leave a comment down below saying I subscribed. I will do my best to reply you as soon as possible. All the necessary files used in this video are mentioned in the description down below, so make sure to check them out. And I will be flashing the latest, that is December 24 build of NitrogenOS 8.1, for which you can find the link in the description. So first, let's talk about the UI and the apps you get pre-installed. As you can see over here, there are not much Google apps, cause I have flashed Pico G apps. And the UI here is stock UI. Now let's go into the settings. Here we have that stock 8.1 layout. Now if you go into the about phone, here we have the latest December 5 security patch and 8.1 Oreo. Now the most important and our favorite feature that makes the NitrogenOS special is the personalization option. It gives a ton of control to the user to play with. Now we are going to take a look at them one by one. First up here we have status bar, under which you get brightness control, using which you can adjust the brightness by sliding on the status bar, and ABD notification and network traffic, etc. And also you can choose the items you want on your status bar with status bar items option. Next we have quick settings, which is self-explanatory. In this you get brightness slider, quick pull down, that is when you pull down the status bar from the right side of the quick settings panel, the quick settings panel automatically expands. And you can also change the rows and columns present in the quick settings panel. Then we have got buttons, where you can customize the function of each and every navigation button, that is home, back and recents button. Then we have got navigation bar, where you can enable virtual navigation bar and adjust its dimensions. And add or remove contents like this. Fifth, we have got gestures, like double tap on status bar to sleep and some AOSP gestures like jump on camera when you press on the power button 2 times. Next we have lock screen contents, where you can enable or disable the contents on your lock screen. The seventh option here is the power menu, which is again self-explanatory, and you can enable or disable the options displayed on pressing the power button. And again you have some general options to customize recent apps menu. Then we have got some notification tweaks like heads up notification, battery charging light, LED indicator for different apps, etc. Tenth feature here is miscellaneous feature. Here you can change the UI style, default, light or dark, and enable MTP instead of charging when connected to PC, and some other options like CPU info, etc. And finally we have got some advanced options, where you can control the intensity of vibration by sliding through this slider, and enable double tap to wake and ambient display. And there are no camera crashing bugs on this ROM. And now I will show you how to flash this ROM if you are a beginner. To flash custom ROM on your device, you need to have a custom recovery and a rooted Android device. If you want to know how to get it, I'll put a card to my older video where I show you exactly how to flash a custom recovery along with unlocking the bootloader. Once you have the requirements, just jump into the recovery by holding volume up and power button at the same time. Here, first go to backup and select all the partitions and swap to backup. This is useful if you run into any problems while flashing the ROM. Now I'm not going to do it as I know this will work for sure. And once that is done, just go to wipe and select all the options except internal and external storage and swipe to wipe. Once that is done, come back and go to install and navigate to the location where you have downloaded the ROM. And first select the ROM and click on add more zip and select the open gaps file that you have downloaded and now swipe to flash. This may take a minute or two and once it is complete, just click on reboot system. And that's it, you have successfully flashed the ROM. Now you may have some questions about this ROM, like do you recommend this ROM for a daily driver? And the answer is yes, absolutely. I have used December 8 build of NitrogenOS 8.1 for more than 2 weeks and it has no major issues at all. And all the common features like VoLTE, Substratum work perfectly fine on this ROM. If you guys have any more questions, then let me know by commenting down below. I'll answer them as soon as possible. And I'll also be showing how to get Pixel 2 like AR stickers on your Redmi Note 3 in coming video. So make sure you subscribe to the channel and hit the bell notification icon and hit the like button if you found this video helpful, and I will see you in my next video.